Scott, this week we're testing our chops as a cyborg ninja on the path of vengeance. Let's check it out. All right, Scott, like I said, this week we're checking out Saijin the Cyborg Ninja. This is actually a pretty cool game. We're checking it out on Steam. I want to preface with saying, because I think this is probably one of the best parts about this game, it's only $11.50. So we're going to get on to how the price and the value works out with this game a little bit later, but I just want to start the review with that because honestly, this is a good price for what we're getting here in this game. Right off the bat, we are actually jumping in as Saijin, and he is a cyborg ninja that has been kind of cast away from his clan, and now he is on the path for vengeance to kind of get back at the people that cast him away. It's a very light story jumping into this game because it kind of gets you right into the gameplay, and that is actually one of the biggest draws here is the way you control your character on screen. Yeah. We are playing this kind of precision platformer puzzle style game, and we're using only the mouse. And this is a really cool way of playing a game because honestly, normally as a gamer, we're used to using both of our hands, especially with a mouse and keyboard situation. But here we're actually playing with just the mouse only. There are options for a couple keyboard controls if you would like, but this game can be solely played with just the mouse. And I thought that was very really, really cool. It made it a little bit difficult because you have to kind of get used to the way that mechanic works. But at the same time, Scott, I actually had a blast playing this game. What did you kind of think jumping into this one?
Well, I looked at the movement and I thought, well, this is interesting. I've only seen this done once before, and that's on Dundara. And that was a pretty interesting game itself. But to see it used in a much more high-paced fashion, I think it fit Saijin really well. But you're hopping around and you're moving through these different levels, and oh boy, can it get punishing.
Oh man, can it ever. I mean, there's six different worlds we travel through here that end each world with a boss, you know, and as we noticed when we went through the first few worlds that you go through, they're, you know, pretty intense, but you kind of get the feel for the game, and they do a good job of kind of spacing the enemies out and giving you checkpoints at what I would consider pretty reasonable, you know, distances apart from each other. But you know what? Even if you finish the first world and jump into the second, the difficulty starts to spike quickly. And I mean, not even just in the boss battles, just getting around the different terrain for each type of world. And they all are kind of changing each time, mostly in color and enemy type. But for the most part, they do a good job because visually, I thought this game looked really good. The movement around screen is very fast paced, so they do a good job at not having too much kind of blur effect or anything like that. Yeah. Everything's very sharp, crisp, and clean the way that it's animated. Honestly, Scott, this one was a ton of fun. I liked the way this game played out, but like you said, the difficulty level is actually where I found myself kind of jumping back out for a little bit because I may be trying to, you know, beat the same stage over and over, and I'm just dying and dying. I'm unlocking achievements on Steam for the amount of times I've died. I know you kind of ran into a couple little quirks with the game. What were some of the things you had issues with?
Yeah, well, it runs smooth almost the whole way through, but it came down to an upgrade mechanic. So there's this little shop that you can stop at basically on every checkpoint, and you use these tokens, and these tokens that you get from saving cats, a little interesting kind of an aside in the game, but you can take these extra routes, save this cat, get a token, and spend that for upgrades. That's pretty straightforward, but I found that I saved, I think, about six cats before I bought upgrades, but they cost double. So instead of costing five, it put me down to -4. So I had to save more cats to work my way back to zero. It was just, I know that's not how that's supposed to work. And that was a little frustrating, but especially frustrating when I need to echo what you said there. There's a lot of these checkpoints spread out, but in World 2 is where it starts to spike, and those checkpoints get few and far between. So when you're lacking some of these upgrades, well, that gets really frustrating. And like you said, again, I kind of ran through it maybe a dozen times and thought, all right, time to take a break. I gotta go. Yeah. I gotta go for a walk, come back. And that's when you boot through it in one try. Like, oh, there's definitely a mental effect that happens from repeating and constantly dying. And that brings a lot of challenge. And I think that is a positive. It sounds a little bit like I'm complaining here, but it's really just frustration because I'm enjoying the mechanics of it, if that makes sense.
Oh no, definitely. I totally agree with you. Well, Scott, I think we've been punished enough in this game, but honestly, like you said earlier, it's kind of the whole fun part about this game is that it is challenging, and they've done a good job here. We're going through six different worlds with six different bosses of increasing difficulty, and honestly, it is a good time. And for your $11.50, I don't think you can beat the value in this game. If you've got to score this one from 1 to 10, Scott, what are you going to give it?
Oh, I am very impressed with this one as well, and it does have that bit of beating you up a bit, but I think that's a punishment that I kind of enjoy nowadays for video games. Stylistically, it looks great. It totally fits, you know, the kind of world that you're jumping through, and the simplicity of one hand doing the mouse movement, I really like that as well. I think that's very unique and solid. This one was an all-around good hit for me. I'm giving this an 8. Very impressed.
Nice, man. You know what? I'm right there with you because I did have a good time playing this game. I didn't have a ton of expectations jumping in because of the price point. You're never really sure how deep of a game you're going to get. But honestly, there is a ton of replayability here because of the difficulty level of this game. I enjoyed my way all the way through using the mouse mechanic only. Like you said, it was a ton of fun. Honestly, I'm up there with an 8.5. A solid platformer for a great price. Challenging levels and boss battles will have you replaying this one for a while.